Greetings. We are Cake. We are here to perform music for you. We are here to entertain you. Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening. We just got this request in for a song from the Netherlands. Thomas Ferguson wants to hear Comfort Eagle. He says, there can only be one request. The reason for canceling your European tour being what it was, only Comfort Eagle really describes our reality today. Thomas, how cryptic. Lauren Dibble wants to hear it. She's from Tempe, Arizona. Greetings, Lauren. Andrew Zinner from Rancho Cordova says, please play Comfort Eagle because my kids crack up every time you say onion head hat. Well, Andrew, this is for your kids. Let's hit it.
Do you believe in the one big sign? The devil white is shine on the foothills
Thomas, I still don't understand what your request means. Only Comfort Eagle really describes our reality today. What are you talking about, Thomas, from the Netherlands? Do we have any more requests coming in? Because we can only play your requests. Let's see, what's this? Okay, 4 years ago, France became football world champion. Cake is happy for France. 60 millions of people singing I Will Survive want to hear it again. Just play it loud, says Joseph Antunes from France, from Vélizy, France. I don't know where that is. Joseph, maybe we'll play it if enough other people want to hear it. Mary Manny's from Los Angeles, California says, why? See, I have these really deformed ears and I need the headphones to cover them up and the song as my anthem. Mary, I don't believe you. Mary's a liar. You can't wear headphones your whole life, Mary. Speaking of the headphones, do we have the headphones? Do we remember to bring the headphones, Vince?
The headphones were, in the vicinity. I think they were on the premises yesterday.
Okay, here's the headphones. Oh, good. These are the headphones. We're going to go ahead and sign them. We haven't signed them yet. And give them away just this hour to whoever can give us the best and most interesting and most convincing request for a song. That's what this is all about, giving away these headphones that were used in our video, Short Skirt, Long Jacket. And people have worn those. I hope that's okay. Just random people off the street have...
How long can germs live on a pair of headphones?
I don't know.
Indefinitely?
Does anybody here at Yahoo have access to a computer and you could maybe find out how long germs would live at regular temperature?
On foam.
On foam, on foam rubber. All right, we're signing the headphones. For the woman in Los Angeles, you know, I'm not sure if this deformed ear reason is a good enough reason. I mean, it's not believable. I don't think that someone with deformed ears would wear headphones their entire life.
Did she send a picture?
No, no picture. So she's not getting the headphones. Sanul Hermawan from a city in Indonesia, which I'm having a hard time pronouncing, says, please play I Will Survive for East Timor people that have just celebrated their freedom from Indonesian army's intimidation. By the song, I wish they keep on surviving. P.S., it is difficult to invite you to come to my city. It's difficult for me to pronounce your city, a cultural city in Indonesia that is falling in love with your songs. Well, we'll think about, when we figure out how to pronounce the name of your city, Yogyakarta, okay? Tell me how that is. But let's go ahead and play the song for you and for the people of East Timor as well. I'm interested that someone from Indonesia is concerned about East Timor when Indonesia is, in fact, the one giving East Timor problems. But anyway, let's go ahead and play this song for him and his friends in East Timor, as well as the deformed ear people and others as well. It's really all about survival. At first I was afraid, I was petrified. I kept thinking I could never live without you by my side. But then I spent so many nights just thinking how you'd done me wrong. I grew strong, I learned how to get along, and so you're back from outer space. I just walked in to find you here with that look upon your face. I should have changed my fucking lock. I would have made you leave your key. If I'd have known for just 1 second you'd be back to bother me. Oh, now go walk out the door. Just turn around. Now you're not welcome anymore. When you the one who tried to break me with desire, did you think I'd crumble? Did you think I'd lay down and die? Oh, not I will survive. Yeah, as long as I know how to love, I know I'll be alive. I've got all my life to live. I've got all my love to give. I will survive. I will survive. Yeah, yeah. Not to fall apart. I'm trying hard to mend the pieces of my broken heart. And I've spent oh so many nights just feeling sorry for myself. I used to cry, but now I hold my head up high. And you'll see me with somebody new. I'm not that stupid little person still in love with you. And so you thought you'd just drop by, and you expect me to be free. But now I'm saving all my loving for someone who's loving me. Oh, now go walk out the door and just turn around. Now you're not welcome anymore. When you were the one who tried to break me with desire, did you think I'd crumble? Did you think I'd lay to give? I will survive. I will survive. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, it's a survival kind of time now. You know, it's I'd like to dedicate that also to the people in the Congo who are trying to survive, as well as the people who are trying to survive everywhere, and in New York City as well. Here's something: how long can germs live on an object? It says. Some disease-causing organisms or pathogens can thrive and multiply for some time, on an object like a phone receiver spattered by saliva or an infected person, but most bacteria and viruses quickly die when moisture disappears, usually after 1 or 2 hours for the saliva spray. There are different pathogens, and some of them can last for days or even months, however, and some might lurk for weeks on an object like a door handle in the house of someone with hepatitis A. Such cases, infectious diseases, they recommend avoiding touching your eyes and mouth, and you can pretty much predict what the experts are saying about it. In other words, you know, don't lick the headphones that we're giving you.
They didn't seem real moist, so they're probably fine.
I think basically they're okay. And let's see, we have a request from a Korean cake listener. Let's see if I can pronounce his name. Sangyun Shim, and he is requesting the song Let Me Go because she said, I guess that we say the words she said, let me go. Hearing like a shipsae means fucker in Korean. If you will play the Let Me Go, many Koreans will crazy about cake. Well, cake wants Korean fans to be crazy about cake or just to go ahead and crazy about cake. So I think we're going to play that song. And then we also have Ryan Imada from Miliani, Hawaii, who says, when we listen to it, the song Let Me Go, when we listen to it in traffic and want to change lanes, we sing Let Me Go and laugh when somebody actually lets us go. Well, that may happen in Hawaii, but it doesn't happen in California, Ryan. We're going to play you our Californian version of Let Me Go, not expecting cars to move for us. All right, so let's go ahead and play that for Ryan and Sangyun.
I wondered
Hey, did we get any requests for the song Nugget by any chance?
Yeah, we did. I saw one.
Is there one in there?
I saw one in there.
I think we're just getting more requests right now. If you'd like to request a song, press the button on your player that says make a request. If you have not already made a request, if you've already made a request, the die is cast. Okay, here's one for opera singer. Do you have Nugget in there too? No, okay.
Yeah, he does. Look, Craig.
Somewhere, there, I think there's maybe a request that came. Well, we could play opera singer too, but let's see. Well, let's see. What else you got there? Let's look at some more. We have Walk On By. Julie Fleming from Brookfield, Connecticut wants to hear Walk On By. I've learned this by ear on my keyboard. I'll play simultaneously on the webcast and feel like I'm in the band. Allow me this fantasy. Well, Cake's not about fantasy, Julie. Walk On By, Eric Carlson from Athens, Ohio wants to hear Walk On By. Walk On By should be played because it is my favorite song and I will be skipping a quiz in my Journalism 233 class to watch your webcast. Pick me because as soon as you're born, you start dying, and I think the Cake webcast will be a better time than my class. Well, Eric, you misinterpreted our song. As James Brown says, stay in school. Can we give Eric a call? Is it possible we could give? Okay, I think we're trying to give Eric a call. Let's give Eric a call. Hello, Eric.
How you doing?
Hi, Eric. This is John McRae from the band Cake, and we're looking at your request here on the webcast, and it says that you skipped your class in order to watch the webcast. Is this the case?
Yeah, but it's okay because one of our lowest grade quiz gets dropped anyway. So
you're rationalizing it.
Yeah, I figure, you know, if one night I might be out having fun instead of studying.
Right.
But this time, and I just doing something better.
Yeah, well, I understand that. I mean, I've come to those kinds of junctures in my life where I've taken the easy path. What do you think, Vince?
I think he sounds like a really reasonable guy.
He does sound reasonable, yeah. and he's got a lot of good reasons for skipping his quiz. But Eric.
Yeah.
We're not going to play your request. I'm sorry.
No.
Yeah, because I hope you understand. We don't want to reward you for skipping class or rationalizing. Cake's motto is stay in school and don't do drugs.
I don't do drugs.
Well,
and I'm a very good student. It's just, it was just 1 hour, and it's not gonna hurt my grade.
But this is a gateway to more lax behavior. So I'm sorry, we're not gonna play it for you. But we do appreciate your requests, and we appreciate your interest in our band, and we hope you let us know. Maybe you could keep in touch and let us know how you do in that class at the end of the.
I will, and maybe you should come to Athens, and I'll take you around and introduce you to my prof and tell you it's okay.
Well, the thing is, I don't care. Our school systems are really decaying, and a lot of professors go along with it, but it doesn't make it right.
Okay.
We're going to be playing, I don't think we're playing in Athens, but I think we are playing in Atlanta, which is probably about a half an hour away.
I'm in Ohio.
Oh, you're in Ohio. There we go. Well, forget it. Athens, Ohio is too far. Well, we'll probably play in your neck of the woods and let us know how it turns out. I'm sure you'll get a good grade. What's that?
I'm sorry. We're going to Cincinnati.
We are going to Cincinnati. So if that's not too far, come to Cincinnati.
I'll make the trip.
Yeah, but, I mean, I realize you're probably going to get a good grade in this class, but we want you to keep on getting good grades, and we don't want to be...
I appreciate that.
Yeah.
I'm glad that the band is concerned about my personal well-being. I think that's just great to show how caring you guys truly are.
Well, sometimes you have to be sort of tough, and we're trying to be tough with you.
I appreciate that.
You know, thanks a lot, and we do appreciate your request, Eric.
Okay.
Good luck in your class.
Thank you.
Okay.
Good luck with the rest of the webcast.
Okay, man. Speaking about being tough, America is trying to be tough now. We were first very afraid, and now we're trying to be tough. And Cake is also trying to be tough, and we have started wearing knives on our belt loops. I don't know if you can get a picture of this, but a lot of people for years and years have made this kind of fashion statement with no problem. But I now am so accustomed to wearing this knife that I don't feel right without it. And so it's prevented us from coming to Europe because they won't let us on the planes carrying knives. But it's a good, it's a handy tool, and I feel like I won't let it go. So if that explains some things that people have been wondering why we aren't coming to Europe or Korea, it has to do with a lifestyle that we've chosen and that we believe in, and we don't feel like changing our lifestyle just because of airport security rules. They can take their rules and shove them as far as we're concerned, because we're going to go on wearing our knives for protection and utility. Here's some requests for opera singer that just came in. Sarah Strauss from Ontario says, "I love you guys. You should play opera singer because you took one of the most boring subjects in the world and turned it into a kick butt song." She uses the word kick butt in her sentence. Sarah, opera is good, and it's really not boring. You should listen to the arias as a gateway and work your way into the recitative, because there's a lot of good music in opera. And also Philippa from London, Europe. I guess London, it's now Europe is a one country, wants to hear opera singer. And she's complaining that we didn't put the time in Greenwich Mean Time on the website. Well, we'd like to formally apologize for not doing that, Philippa. We were too busy and we couldn't get around to it. Opera singer Jeanette Rudolph from Germany also would like to hear opera singer. Fernando Cordeiro de Castro from Brazil says, "Bring my chances so little by playing my cake request. Cake will cause a paradox in Murphy's Law. Then they'll sell more records than Backstreet Boys." Well, we hope so. But I'm not holding my breath, Fernando. Let's go ahead and play you the song, though. We appreciate your requests. Feel free to make more requests as this hour progresses. Let's go ahead and play the song for Fernando and Sarah.
Opera singer, I stand on painted tape. It tells me where I'm going and where to throw my cape. And I call my co-star's brother, I call my co-star's name. I play both parts, I sing to Verdi's grave. And every single morning by 10 a.m. I'm dressed. My rehearsals last for hours and hours with diligence. I have been blessed. They call me monster. tries to tell me that they love my voice, just to tell me that I'm great. And I am an opera singer. I will sing when you're all dead. I'd sing the mountains crumbling apart. I'd sing what can't be said.
I was just thinking, you know, to the guy that skipped class, you know, that last song was a song about discipline. Thanks, Brian. Brian, why don't you come on up here? People are seeing the back of you, but this is Brian. Smile for the camera. Brian's getting the requests. Some of them are coming in right now. And, you know, what do you think, Brian? Are we getting any more interesting requests, or are they all just sort of not interesting? Okay, all right. Well, if we get some interesting requests, will you bring them to me?
Sure.
Okay, thanks. We'll see you later, Brian. Brian just brought a request for the song Nugget. Kristen in Germany wants to hear Nugget because it persuaded her not been to a record store since Hendrix died dad that there's a life after Woodstock. Well, thanks, Kristen. We hope that your dad enjoys our music. Melanie from Western Australia would like us to play Cake. She would like to us to dedicate the song as Shut the Fuck Up, Craig. He pisses off too many people by talking too much shit. Hence his nickname is, I guess, Shut the Fuck Up, Craig is his nickname. Well, Craig, I don't have anything against you, but apparently Melanie does. So we're gonna play this song for Melanie, and Craig, maybe you should reconsider talking so much shit about people all the time.
One, two, ready, begin. State who ride and wrangle, look at your face from more than one angle, can cut you from their bloated budgets like sharpened knives through chicken McNuggets. Now heads of state who ride and wrangle, look at your face from more than one angle, can cut you from their bloated budgets like sharpened knives through chicken McNuggets.
Shut the fuck up.
Thank you.
Now, nimble fingers that dance on numbers will eat your children and steal your thunder, while heavy torsos that heave and hurl will crunch like nuts in the mouths of squirrels. Now, nimble fingers that dance on numbers will eat your children and steal your thunder, while heavy torsos that heave and hurl will crunch like nuts in the mouths of squirrels. Shut the fuck. Shut the fuck.
Shut the fuck.
Smoky spires do more to turn my joy to sadness than somber thoughts of burning planets. Now clever feet that flicker like fire and burn like candles in smoky spires do more to turn my joy to sadness than somber thoughts of burning planets.
Shut the fuck.
Because I don't wanna hear it. Any other interesting requests? Okay. What else we got there? Anything else? I don't know if I want to play that one yet. This just in. What else we have? Let's see. Okay. How about let's play? Let's see if we can play this one. Hang on to these for me for a minute, and maybe we'll feel like that one later. Actually, let me see what else we have. These are coming in as we speak, aren't they? This is about germs. Okay, and this we just played. We'll put the ones we just played here. What do you guys feel like playing? Do you feel like playing Meanwhile Rick James or Mr. Mastodon Farm or?
That sounds good.
Those are good.
Okay, well, you're right the first time. Here. There we go. Matthias Glassel from München, Germany, that's Munich, and to you Americans. He says that it's a shame we don't come to Europe. Right now, you're so much safer in Europe than in the U.S. Well, if they would let us carry our knives, he would like us to play Mr. Mastodon Farm for the reason that my request is that it reminds me of my beloved canary Woodstock dying almost exactly 2 years ago. Stealing small loads of cakes. I think this is made up. I don't think that it's too convenient that the canary is stealing cakes. Sorry. And we have Jeffrey Sharkey. He says that children love the song Mr. Mastodon Farm. Children love it. His youngest son of four mimics it. He claims to know what all songs are about. He never had that claim on this one. Well, let's play this song for your four-year-old, Jeffrey. I'm not sure if I know what this song is about. Birds fall from the window ledge above mine. Then they flap their wings at the last second. We'll be right back. Birds fall from the window ledge above mine. Then they flap their wings at the last second. I can see their dead weight just dropping like stones or small loaves of bread past my window all the time. But unless I get up and walk across the room, I don't see their last minute curves toward flight. Now, due to a construct in my mind that makes their falling and their flight symbolic of my entire existence, it becomes important for me to get up and see their last second curves toward flight. It's almost as if my life will fall. My life will fall unless I see their ascent. Mr. Mastodon Farm, Mr. Mastodon Farm, cuts watches out of all material. Mr. Mastodon Farm, Mr. Mastodon Farm, cuts watches out of all. The window ledge above mine, then they flap their wings at the last second. Birds fall from the window ledge above mine, then they flap their wings at the last second. But unless I get up and walk across the room, I don't see their last second curves towards flight. It's almost as if my life will fall unless I see their ascent. Now, due to a construct in my mind that makes their falling and their flight symbolic of my entire existence, it becomes important for me to get up and see their last second curves toward flight. Hey, Mr. Mastodon Farm, Mr. Mastodon Farm, the watches out of all material. Mr. Mastodon Farm, Mr. Mastodon, keep going, cut some watches out of all material. Mr. Mastodon Farm, Mr. Mastodon, cut some watches out of all material.
All right. What else we got here? Anything else? Anything new? Okay. All right. Wow. Ahmad Nazir from Pakistan says, my dear. thanks, Ahmad. My dear, I am very happy when I hear your opportunity. My name is Ahmad Nazir. My request is a song, Anyone of Brittany. I am a fan of Brittany. That's all. Bye-bye. Well, thanks, Ahmad. We appreciate your musical taste. We have a request from Brandy Weiser for Short Skirt, Long Jacket. It says, I want to request Short Skirt, Long Jacket be played tomorrow. Our son was conceived to that song. My husband wanted our son to be called Cake, but I opted for Scott. Thanks. Brandy, I'm not sure if I believe that. That's a short song, too. It's a short conception. Okay, let's see, what else do we have? My request is short skirt, no band, no writer, nobody ever summed up the desires of the male species better, says Glenn Butcher of Milburn, New Jersey. Thanks, Glenn. I'm not sure if that's what that song's about, but thanks for your request. Also, Dana Wiley from Barcelona, Spain, has a very simple request. It just says, short skirt, long jacket, please. I have needs. I have needs. That's probably the shortest request that we have gotten from Dana. That's a great request. I have needs. We all have needs. Okay, let's go ahead and play a song for these people that are having needs and conceiving children. Okay. All right. This is a song. This is from Ray Grossman. Looks like it just came in. He would like to hear The Distance. He needs motivation that the song inspires. His car broke down this morning, and yesterday his dog died, and he can't get any of his kids to leave home. I don't think that sounds too cliche. What do you think? It sounds like he just sort of listened to a country song and then made up a fake song request. I don't believe you, sir. Cone Philippe's from Belgium, he says he would like us to play The Distance for obvious reasons. They are playing on the net, far away from their audience, but through
the speed of telephone lines in the middle of every fan's home. Well, that's true, isn't it? It's you must have a very analytical brain. You have the speed, and you have the far away motif. Well, that's interesting, Cone. And let's see, we have a request from Kathmandu in Nepal.
The name is Moljolnir Uru. I'm sorry if I'm mispronouncing your name. It says, I always listened to The Distance on my Walkman, pedaling home from work in Kathmandu, Nepal. Whenever I hear it, I'm flying down Kantipath again. Well, I guess Kantipath is a street that has a hill on it, and he's flying down it on his bicycle. Well, that's a nice image. I like that.
Be careful not to get in a crash on your bicycle. This is from Reba. Reba, it doesn't say where she's from, but I imagine it's the United States of America. Reba says, Dear Cake, please play The Distance, as it encouraged me to go for speed as it played while I was giving birth to my daughter.
Heard that before.
This is either made up or something. I think it might be made up. Do we have Reba's phone number? Can we give her a call right now? Let's see if Reba really gave birth to her daughter. I want to try to get her to be honest about it. Hello?
Hi.
Hi, is this Reba?
It sure is.
Hi, Reba. My name is John. I play in the band Cake, and we're doing this webcast thing, and you made a request for The Distance, and you said in your request that it encouraged you to go for speed while it played while you're giving birth to your daughter. Now, there are a couple things I'm wondering.
Uh-huh.
Okay. Did you have your child in a hospital?
Yes, luckily I did.
And it was okay with the doctors to have loud rock music in the background during the birth?
I'm not sure he noticed, actually. They encouraged us to bring CDs and players, all to make me feel more relaxed.
Do they do this now? Really?
Yeah.
Okay,
it's
well,
like a party.
I am ignorant about the birth party motif, but... So you're really telling the truth about giving birth to your daughter with this song in the background.
Yep.
Because I thought...
I am.
Reba, I thought you were lying.
No, and she picked The Distance to actually be born on, so...
Oh, really? So
yeah.
That's a motivational song for sure.
Mm-hmm.
Is that Elizabeth, your child, in the background?
Yeah, that's her. She's talking away.
How old is Elizabeth?
She's 13 months now.
Well, Cake, I guess, would like to officially congratulate you on a successful birth. And you know, you just really surprised us because we really didn't think that anybody who is going through the pain of childbirth would want to hear loud rock music.
I figured it would help.
Really? You felt like it helped? Well, that's good. I mean, is there anything else? Well, do you think that that this child is particularly... motivational kind of person? Is this a child that's going to be a forceful presence in the world?
I think so. She's certainly trying to now, that's for sure.
Good.
She's trying to forcefully take the phone away from me, actually.
Really? Excellent. I mean, does she want to talk to us, or?
You want to talk to her? She might just listen. You can if you want.
Okay, well, we'll just say hi, Elizabeth, and then we'll say goodbye.
Okay. Well, hold on one sec.
Okay.
Hey, Elizabeth. It's Cake on the phone. Hold on. Here she is.
Hi, Elizabeth. Hi, Elizabeth.
Well, she smiled and then tried to put the phone in the kitchen.
Oh, good. Well, that's where the phone should go when Cake is on the other line.
That's true.
We don't want Cake calling small children. Well, it's nice to talk to you, Reba, and I'm really pleased, actually, that you were telling the truth, and you might win our headphones because that's just such a weird thought for us. But we'll give you a call back if that happens.
That's great.
Well, no, you haven't won the headphones yet. We have to see who else gives some more requests. So, but we appreciate your request, and thanks very much, and good luck to you and your daughter.
Thank you. Thank you.
Okay, take
Thanks
care.
Thanks for calling.
All right.
Bye.
That was weird. That was very strange. I'm still recovering. Can we go a little bit past the hour? Is that okay? All right. We're going to give you a little extra music content. We are content providers. Fairly unimportant in the scheme of things, but we're going to provide some more content right now. Reluctantly crouched at the starting line, engines pumping and thumping in time. The green light flashes, the flags go up. Churning and burning, they yearn for the cup. They deftly maneuver and muscle for rank. Fuel burning fast on an empty tank. Reckless and wild, they pour through the turns. Their prowess is potent and secretly stern. As they speed to the finish, the flags go down. The fans get up and they get out of town. The arena is empty, except for one man still driving and striving as fast as he can. The sun is gone down and the moon has come up. And long ago somebody left with the cup. But he's driving and striving and hugging the turns and thinking of someone for whom he still burns. He's going the distance. He's going for speed. She's all alone in a time of need. Because he's racing and pacing and plotting the course. He's fighting and riding and riding on his horse. He's going the distance. No flashbulbs, no wine. He's haunted by something he cannot define. Bow-shaking earthquakes of doubt and remorse assail him, impale him with monster drug force. In his mind, he's still driving, still making the grade. She's hoping in time that her memories will fade. Cause he's racing and pacing and plotting the course. He's fighting and fighting and riding on his horse. He'll be down as the moon has come down. And long ago, somebody left with the cup. But he's driving and striving and hugging the turns and thinking of someone for whom he still burns. He's going the distance. He's going for speed. She's all alone in a time of need. Because he's racing and pacing and plotting the course. He's fighting and fighting and riding on his horse. He's racing and pacing and plotting the course. He's fighting and fighting and riding on his horse. He's going the distance. He's going for speed. He's going the distance. Gabe Nelson on bass guitar. Gabe, were you, as you were playing that song, were you thinking about childbirth?
I'm always thinking about childbirth.
Gabe Nelson on bass guitar, always thinking about childbirth. Zan McCurdy on guitar, did the thought of childbirth cross your mind as you were playing?
It did. Okay. I thought about it, but I thought we should have been saying she's going the distance.
That's right. That's right. Well, that would have been probably... maybe a little too cute.
Yeah,
I think maybe we don't want to pander. Okay, so what song do we feel like playing next? Is there anything we feel like playing next?
I don't know. I was just thinking, "Won't Get Fooled Again" would be a great childbirth song with a scream. We just get the scream at the right moment.
Yeah, we don't know "Won't Get Fooled Again," but that would be good because of the scream that always. Heralds the beginning of human life. It's always starting with screaming and crying, and that's probably indicative of what it's going to be like the rest of the time.
Hey, all this life stuff. How about "Love You Madly"? You know,
yeah.
Like, you
know.
Could do that. Well, let's see if we have a. Do we have any more requests? What do we have here? We have "I Bombed Korea." "I Bombed Korea" is requested by Hong Hee Kim. He's actually Korean, I assume. And that's a strange request that you would want to be bombed in a song. It says, 40 years ago, you bombed Korea with a bomb. Well, Cake did not bomb Korea. We may have indirectly prospered from the burgeoning growth of the military-industrial complex, and that could have given our parents some extra spending money, but we did not choose to bomb Korea. You are still bombing Korea with a different kind of weapon, so-called music. What a sweet pain. I'd like to read that again. In 40 years ago, you bombed Korea with a bomb. You are still bombing Korea with different kind of weapon, so-called music. What a sweet pain. That's nice. This says, this is from Katie from Kansas City. She would like us to play I Bombed Korea. For the past 4 years, she has been a Cake fan. When we came into Kansas City, she was so happy that she counted down the days to the concert. A week before the concert, this is, she says, she got sick with pneumonia and was so sick that she couldn't even get out of her bed. It was the worst day of her life. My boyfriend and his friend said that while sitting at a red light, John offered them tickets through the window of their limousine. You may or may not remember this. Okay, your boyfriend is lying, Katie, because pretty much Cake doesn't travel in limousines. We travel in a van 99% of the time. So check into your boyfriend's story, and I don't think I'm going to play that request because your boyfriend is a liar. We didn't hand anybody tickets out of the limousine.
Were
so
they, maybe they were in the limousine, and we were walking on the side.
No, he said that we were. I think it said that we were in the limousine. I don't think the boyfriend's traveling around in the limousine. Okay. Well, so we're not going to do that one because we don't like liars. Let's see. Oh, this is too long and complicated. We did say 25 words or less. This is a request from a man named Mozart who lives in Brazil. He wants us to play Long Line of Cars. If you play this song, it's really amazing. That's a great reason. Allison from London wants us to play Long Line of Cars because it doesn't look like that she's going to be able to see us play live for quite some time. Well, we'll see about that. Maybe you can call your local record company representatives and ask them to let us come play for you. It looks like Todd from I Can't Tell Where, is it Placerville, California, wants us to play Long Line of Cars to alleviate his rage in his afternoon commute. That sounds like a Todd. 16 miles, no road, all cars, all sin. Well, I don't feel like playing that song. Let's see, what else do we have? Love You Madly. This is from Italy. Greetings, Italy. This is from Andrea Margiotta, who is from Torino in Italy. And he says, you will play Love You Madly. Why? I don't know why I love you madly, but I do. But you do. Okay, only for you. Bye-bye. Hi, Andrea. I'm trying to understand exactly what you're saying, but it seems like you want us to play Love You Madly. Here we go. Let's go ahead and play Love You Madly. Why not? We'll be right back. us for the entire country of Italy. Actually, we've gotten all kinds of requests, lots and lots of requests for songs, but really, we're just picking out the requests that seem interesting and have, you know, detailed descriptions of interesting events. This is from Edinburgh. Miriam Sturdy would like to hear the song Sheep Go to Heaven. She says, please play Sheep Go to Heaven or Rabid Gerbils Will Eat Me Alive. Cheers. She's just joking. I don't believe that that's really true. We wanted a real reason, Miriam. This is from Kevin Hards of Essex, England. Kevin says, I think that Cake should play my request of Sheep Go to Heaven because I only have one leg. Both of these people are trying to play on our sympathy, and I don't think that we should play their request because it seems like people in the United Kingdom are just liars today. Oh, let's play it anyway. You want to play that song?
Yeah, let's do it.
All right. This is for the other people that didn't lie to us that requested the song.
Trip. I don't want to feel the emptiness of both our ears with stupid band-aids. I don't want to go to Sunset Strip. I don't want to go to Sunset Strip. I don't want to feel the emptiness of both our ears with stupid band-aids. I don't want to go to Sunset Strip. All right, oh yeah. Go to heaven.
loves Stickshifts and Safetybelts. She draws Cake in concert, always in carrot costumes, and says, I love this band, they're called Pie. Well, she is a very witty six-year-old. What the hell? Let's just go ahead and play this. Kevin Finkelstein says it's the first song, the Cake song that he learned to play. First Cake song my girlfriend and I made love to. Please, Kevin Finkelstein. And he says that the 22nd of January is their anniversary. Matt Luttrell, or otherwise AKA Louie, says you should play Stickshifts and Safetybelts because if you don't, I will drown my hamster in a dirty toilet. No, you won't. And Lelena Neufeld from Canada. We like Canada. Don't we like Canada? Yeah.
Great, great, great place.
Canada's great. Says, I'm earnestly requesting Stickshifts and Safetybelts because, like you, I feel carbon emissions and subsequent global warming are far less important than love. Well, I think that love is not possible in a world with too much carbon emissions. So you're going to lose your love if you lose the air, don't you think?
Yeah. That's quite a common. That's carrots, sex, carbon emissions, and even one other thing that was pretty interesting.
Yeah.
To hamsters and toilets.
And the marital relationships, power dynamics in marriage.
That was something else.
How is he going to spend his money? Okay, let's go ahead.
Bucket seats have all got to go when we're driving in the car. It makes my baby seem so far. To get right next to you, I say, baby, scoot over, please. And then she's right there next to me. I need you here with me, not way over in a bucket seat. I need you to be here with me, not way over in a bucket seat. All right. Yeah, we're a lot of good cars. Bucket seats have all got to go when we're driving in the car. It makes my baby seem so far. I need you here with me, not way over in a bucket seat. I need you to be here with me, not way over in a bucket seat. All right, oh no, oh yeah.
All right, we're running out of time. We have to not only play a couple more songs, we also have to decide whose request was the best. Frank Sinatra is the song that Heiko from Germany would like us to play. He's from Stuttgart. Mike Keane from Australia also wants us to play that song. Nick Irvine from Kent, England wants us to play Frank Sinatra. A lot of requests for Frank Sinatra. A song from our second album, Fashion Nugget. It looks like Barend from Holland would also like to hear that song. Thank you, Barend, for your request. And Barnaby from Oregon. She says, my request for Frank Sinatra, it's our favorite camping song. Who would have known that the song would be used for camping? We sing it because the whole family remembers all the words. Let's see if I can remember the words. And Okay, well, that sounds great. Let's go ahead and play it. That's enough convincing for me.
Constellations, a faintly glimmering radio station. Well, Frank Sinatra sings stormy weather. The flies and spiders get along together. Cobwebs fall on an old skipping record. Beyond the suns that guard this roost, beyond your flowers of flaming truth, beyond your latest ad campaigns. An old man sits collecting stamps in a room all filled with Chinese lamps. He saves what others threw away. That he'll be rich someday. We know of an ancient radiation that haunts dismembered constellations, a faintly glimmering radio station. Radiation that haunts dismembered constellations, a faintly glimmering radio station. While Frank Sinatra sinks stormy weather, the flies and spiders get along together.
And that's the way we're going to have to leave you, because we've run out of time. Who do you think we should give the headphones to? Vince DiFiore on trumpet.
Oh boy, I don't know. There's a lot of, seems like a lot of, you know, requests and hardships and needs and, you know, a lot of desire for headsets, basically. So
yeah, where are those headphones?
It's a toss-up.
I almost think that, you know, childbirth is so primary.
I was thinking about that.
You know, and I'm sorry that it's going to an American, but I mean, maybe it'll persuade European hospitals to allow rock music. I don't know if it'll make a difference, but I think that we're going to go ahead and. Do you think you could, Brian? Could you look through this for the one on the childbirth one? I think that's the person who gets these because really childbirth is really what it's all about for humans on this planet, and you know we need to control it and contain it, but it's very important. And Cake would like to thank you for coming to our show on the internet. And congratulations to Reba for winning these headphones. Here you go, Reba. Thank you very much.
Is it over?
Yeah, I guess we're done.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so it's not over yet. We're going to play a song on the way out as it fades away. We're going to play one more song. How's that? Okay. Let's go ahead and play
Never There.
Thank you very much for coming to our concert, and we hope you have had a good time. This is a song from our third album, Prolonging the Magic, and it goes like this. I need your arms around me, I need to feel your touch.
Hey!
I need your understanding, I need your love. That you love me so, you tell me that you care, but when I need you, baby,
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 you're never there.
On the phone, long, long distance, always through such strong resistance. First you say you're too busy, I wonder if you even miss me. That flies away, a candle's fickle flame.
Hey!
To think I held you yesterday, your love was just a game. A golden bird that flies away, a candle's fickle flame.
Hey!
To think I held you yesterday, your love was just a game.
Hey!
You tell me that you love me so, you tell me that you care, but when I need you, baby,
baby,
baby, take the time to get to know me. If you want me, why can't you just show me?
We are building a religion, we are building it bigger,